Hi, this is Dr. Shawn Talbott, Chief Science Officer for MonaVie, and welcome to another edition of From the Lab. Today, I thought what we'd do is talk about some of the very recent media reports that maybe you've seen already around this idea that too many antioxidants can actually be bad for you. We've seen stories just over the last few weeks coming from the magazine Scientific American, from the radio program on National Public Radio, and even from the Dr. Oz show, all with the headline, so to speak, that too many antioxidants can be bad for your health. And I think we should start right off by saying that, yes, in some ways, too many antioxidants can be bad for your health because it sets off a chain reaction of imbalance in the body. And we can get into that in just a little bit. But what I want to focus you on first is that the takeaway message from every single one of those reports, Scientific American, National Public Radio, and the Dr. Oz Show, is sure, too many of certain kinds of antioxidants can be bad, but what we still want people to understand is that antioxidant balance is good for your health. We do want to get ourselves in a situation of getting just the right balance of just the right kinds of antioxidants to improve our health. It's often what I refer to as the Goldilocks phenomenon, where too few antioxidants, which is where 99% of the population is, that's really bad for your health. The other end of the extreme, where you can overdose with antioxidants, that can also be bad for your health in certain ways. But where we want to encourage people to get is in the middle, where they're getting small amounts of several types of antioxidants every single day. That's really what we want to do. And you know, that's really where MonaVie products have been all along for the whole history of this company. It's been about antioxidant balance. Whereas a lot of companies in our industry have been the other way. They've been about more is better. They've been about focusing you on one type of antioxidant and having you take a mega dose of that under the guise that this might be better, more is better. And in this case, it's not always better. Sometimes more can be worse. So that brings me to a discussion that I want to have with you about this measurement called ORAC. O-R-A-C, oxygen radical absorbance capacity. It's a term that's thrown around in our industry very, very widely. People will claim that they have a high ORAC and they'll associate that with being a good product or a more potent product. And it really isn't cracked up to be that sort of a measurement. When we think about ORAC, it's really a test tube measurement. It's something that can tell us the antioxidant potential of an ingredient or of a collection of ingredients in a test tube or in a bottle, if you will. So the example I like to give to people is that you could have a very high ORAC score for a particular product or a particular ingredient, but then that ingredient or that product might not have any antioxidant benefit at all in the body. And that's the difference between what's in the bottle and what happens biologically. And the difference between those two things can be caused by, you know, a lot of places in the chain of events. So you could have a high ORAC here, but it's not digested appropriately, or it's digested too much, and so it's inactivated. So you could have a problem at the digestion level. You could have a problem at the absorption level. So that high ORAC ingredient or product doesn't get into the body. It could get absorbed, but then it might not get transported correctly. It could get transported, but then it doesn't get deposited in the target tissue. It could get deposited in the target tissue, but then the body filters it out very quickly, something that we will measure as retention. It could get deposited there, but then it goes away very quickly. You know, so there's lots of different places in the chain of events going from bottle to biology or bottle to actual health benefit where a product can fail. And so one of the things we pride ourselves on at MonaVie is measuring the product here in the bottle, but then measuring an outcome, measuring flexibility, measuring some aspect of antioxidant damage, measuring some aspect of people feeling better or performing better, so that you know that what's in here actually has the benefit in the body, in the person, in the user that you actually want it to. So that's a big differentiator between the way we do antioxidants here at MonaVie around this idea of balance and the way a lot of companies do antioxidants around the idea of more is better. And what we're finding now, especially from these new reports that are coming out, is that very often more is not better. And a really good example of that is what we know right now for isolated synthetic antioxidants taken at very high doses, like vitamin E, for example. You know, there was a period of time for years where we knew that low levels of vitamin E were associated with more oxidation in the body, more damage. And the idea was, well, let's give a lot more of that. Let's give high doses of vitamin E and we'll prevent that oxidation and therefore we'll improve health. And what we're actually finding is that the way it's been delivered, taking very high levels, megadose, of an isolated antioxidant, vitamin E, typically as one of the eight different types of vitamin E, just alpha tocopherol, and giving that to people sets off this imbalancing effect in the body. Taking just a high dose of that one type of vitamin E actually blocks out some of the other types of vitamin E. So you end up causing oxidation in the body instead of preventing it. So what you'll see when you look at MonaVie products is none of that. You'll never see a high dose synthetic isolated antioxidant. You'll see a little bit of vitamin C. You'll see a little bit of vitamin E. You'll see some flavonoids. You'll see some carotenoids. You'll see some thiols. And what that is a representation of the antioxidant network. Each of those five categories of nutrients performs a different role. They're all antioxidants, but they fight against different kinds of free radicals. They fight against those different kinds of free radicals in different parts of our body. And so the MonaVie products have always been built around that idea of balance. Excuse me. When we do that, when we build with balance and we build with members of each one of these members of the antioxidant network, our outcome is significantly better. You get a better overall protective ability if you have several different antioxidants working together. And one of the reasons I already mentioned, they fight against different kinds of free radicals and they fight against different, and they fight in different parts of the body. But they also help each other. So vitamin C can regenerate vitamin E. Vitamin E can help carotenoids. Carotenoids can help flavonoids. Flavonoids can help your body produce its own thiols. So it really is this coordinated, synergized combination of the team approach versus any one superstar. That's really what you need to take away when you think about antioxidants. So when you look back to the Scientific American article or the NPR story or the Dr. Oz episode that aired recently, what you really want to take away is, yes, the headline, too many of these isolated antioxidants can be bad, so let's avoid that. But also, don't forego your antioxidant supplements completely, because most of us are in this low state. We're not eating enough fruits and vegetables. We're exposed to these free radicals and these sources of oxidation on a continual basis every minute of the day. We want to protect ourselves from that. So don't go too high. Don't go too low. Go with Goldilocks in the middle. Go right to that balance point. And that's exactly what these MonaVie products are doing. So, you know, if you want to do a deep dive into some of those research studies, the research studies from Tufts University and Johns Hopkins University showing a higher intake of carotenoids is associated with a range of health benefits, or the recent studies that are coming out of Harvard University's medical school and Harvard University's public health school and show that flavonoids are associated with a whole suite of health benefits for the brain, for the heart, for your bones, for so many parts of your body. If you want to see that kind of research and actually read the abstracts and read the papers, go visit MonaVie's blog site right now. I've written an article that will post the exact same time that you're watching this video, and you can read into those details. You can go and you can see what Dr. Oz says about it. You can read what I've written for the Dr. Oz show about antioxidant balance. You can read what researchers at these top shelf universities are saying about carotenoids and flavonoids and this idea of antioxidant balance. And then you can make your own decision. Do you want to be the high dose isolated where the problems are? Do you want to be the low dose area where it is associated with a range of other problems? Or do you want to be where we are at MonaVie with this balanced approach that truly is associated with what you want, which is health and longevity and feeling better? That's what MonaVie is all about, delivering that nutrition in a science-based way so that you can actually use it and get benefits from what's in here and bring those benefits in here into your body. So check out the blog, check out the science tab on MonaVie.com for all of the other studies that we've done and all of the institutes that we've worked with, not just antioxidants, because even though antioxidants are are sort of your doorway into the MonaVie universe, it's just one piece of the puzzle. Antioxidants are maybe where you'll start, but then we want to talk to you about your energy levels and your blood sugar levels and your stress levels and what your body fat looks like and all those other aspects, all those other switches, if you will, where we know we can help you feel better. So check out those areas. Share this video with your friends. Check out the blog. Check out the science tab. And then join me next week for another edition of From the Lab. This is Dr. Shawn Talbott. Thanks a lot.